The Zera Shimshon of Parashat Korach tells us how the wife of On ben Pelet knew that he could still do Teshuvah. When Korach and his followers are punished, On ben Pelet is not mentioned between them. Why? The Gemara in Masachet Sanhedrin explains that the wife of On saved the husband from being punished along with the followers of Korach. She told him, "What does it make a difference to you who the leader is, if it's this leader or that leader? You will always be a student of either one of them anyway." He said to her, "What could I do? I already made a decision and I gave an oath that I'm going to join them." She told him, "The entire assembly is holy." Now these words are what we're going to talk about today. She told the husband, "Stay here, I will save you." She gave him a drink and he went to sleep, and she put him to bed inside the tent, and she uncovered her hair and she sat by the entrance of the tent. And when the assembly of Korach came, they saw her, that the hair was uncovered, and they turned around and they went back. So the Zera Shimshon asked a question. Why did she say to her husband, "The entire assembly is holy"? What has to do with her husband? Her husband is sleeping now. He doesn't know what's going on. So why did she have to mention, and what does that mean? The Yalkut Reuveni tells us that right at the beginning, when Korach and his followers opposed to Moshe, Moshe reacted by falling on his face and he prayed to Hashem, and Hashem told him that Korach is going to be punished, which means that Moshe Rabbeinu understood that his followers still had a chance to do Teshuvah. So the Zera Shimshon explains that On listened to his wife, but he really thought he was stuck, because he said, "For sure I'm going to get punished." Because Bilam, what happened before the time of Bilam? He gave the advice to Paro to drown the Jewish babies, and he got punished. So he said, "Since I'm with the older people, with the whole assembly, for sure he's going to get punished." But his wife said that they're all holy, and she was saying to her husband that they all have a chance to do Teshuvah. So when she mentioned that they're all holy, that means that they all could do Teshuvah and they had a chance. How did she know this? If they had no chance to do Teshuvah, then Moshe would not call them to resolve the issue. Why would he waste their time if it was too late to do Teshuvah? Only Korach had no chance, because Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu. But they all had a chance to do Teshuvah. So the Zera Shimshon adds also at the end, and he says that when Moshe said to Korach, "Listen to me, sons of Levi," why do you have to mention, "Listen to me, sons of Levi"? Just say, "Listen to me, Korach," like he's talking to Korach. The answer is that Moshe Rabbeinu wasn't speaking to Korach because Korach had no chance, but he was speaking to his followers. And this is what the wife of On was saying to her husband. "Don't worry, I'm going to save you. Go inside. They're all holy. You all have a chance to do Teshuvah." And that's why she ended up saving his life, because she knew this kind of information. And he was saved. This is the Zera Shimshon of Parashat Korach. Shabbat Shalom Umevorach.